Epson, you know that company that's known for its printers and scanners? They are the latest company to enter the wearable market with a line of running watches and activity trackers. I'm Dan Graziano and I'm here with the Epson RunSense SF810. This isn't a smartwatch and it's not an activity tracker, but rather a GPS-equipped running watch. Not only can you measure your pace and distance when running, but you can also measure your beats per minute. The best part is that you don't have to wear one of those uncomfortable chest straps, thanks to the optical heart rate sensor on the back of the watch. I compared the heart rate sensor to a polar chest strap and found the results to be nearly identical, which is quite impressive. I was also impressed with how accurate the GPS tracking was, which was on par, if not better, than competing products from Garmin and Polar. What I liked the most about the watch was the amount of data it presented. The SF810 features 35 different data points that you can pick and choose to display across four customizable screens, which gives you the option of displaying one, two, or three lines of data points on each. I was also impressed with the battery life. With both the active GPS signal and heart rate tracking turned on, it will last 20 hours. This is compared to 10 hours on the similarly equipped Garmin Forerunner 225. Overall, I got about 2 weeks of usage out of the SF810 before I was required to charge it. During this time, I used the GPS and heart rate sensor for around 30 to 40 minutes, 4 to 5 times a week. It's also a good thing you don't have to charge it often because doing so requires you connect it to the Mammoth-sized charging cradle, which can be a huge pain to carry around. Now, I did run into some issues when attempting to acquire a GPS signal in New York City. Epson has an assisted GPS feature which will pre-cache your location on your watch using your smartphone, but even with this enabled, the watch would take longer than the Garmin Forerunner 225 and Polar M400. Even on some days, it just couldn't get a signal. I was also turned off by Epson's Run Connect mobile app. It's one of the worst things about using the SF810. Not only is the upload process slow and at times unreliable, but overall navigation through the menu is met with loading icons and frequent delays. There's also no automatic syncing. You are instead required to hold the lap button to initiate sync mode and then manually upload each run. The SF810 is a bit pricey as well. In the US, it will run you $350. That's $50 more than the Garmin Forerunner 225, which has heart rate tracking and adds all-day activity tracking. But the SF810 could still be an appealing purchase simply for the accurate tracking and the impressive battery life. For more information, check out my full review over at CNET.com. I'm Dan Graziano for CNET, and that was a first look at the Epson RunSense SF810.